We are with Dr. Paul Spindt, Professor of Banking and Finance at Tulane University. Dr. Spindt, welcome. How important are the capital markets for the economic development of a country? In other words, do you think that there is a direct relationship between the real economy and the financial markets?
Well, financial markets are critical to the development of economies. They're interlinked and they provide the raw materials for businesses to get going. Without financial markets, commercial operations simply can't take place. They freeze.
And which are the main determinants to develop strong capital markets in a country?
Probably the main determinant would be transparency and access to information by investors. I guess the second main development would be a set of regulations that allows the development of capital markets in an unfettered sort of way. If you have capital constraints or if you have information problems, capital markets simply can't develop.
How important is for entrepreneurs to have access to well-developed capital markets?
Well, again, if entrepreneurs or business people in general can't get access to credit, they can't get access to the funds they need to expand and develop. But it's especially important for entrepreneurs because entrepreneurs always have good ideas. They always have projects that they'd like to develop. But unless they can get the investments, the money to support those developments, they won't be able to develop. They won't be able to start their businesses and they won't be able to function as entrepreneurs.
And would you expect a flourishing of entrepreneurial initiatives as the capital markets become more developed?
That I certainly would expect that. As capital markets become more developed, more possible sources of financing are put in place, different new ventures and whatnot can be financed by those capital markets.
Many emerging markets have restricted access to different types of financial institutions and securities. Do you consider that these emergent markets should focus in promote the development of such institutions and securities, or they should or become part of the global financial system? For example, should corporations focus in raising capital in the local markets or in the international global markets?
Well, in many situations as it stands now, they don't have the local choice. They must raise money in the global markets in order to raise the kind of capital that's needed. But emerging economies should certainly focus on developing local capital markets to make them more transparent, make credit more easily available. This is especially important for small and medium-sized enterprises that simply don't have access to the global markets.
You have mentioned transparency. What does transparency mean in this context?
Transparency means that the potential investors, the ones who have the capital to lend or to purchase equity in firms, need to be able to see what the kind of work that their money is doing so that they understand what use it's being put to. An opaque work their money is doing. And they need to be able to see what the kind of work that their money is doing so that they understand what use it's being put to. An opaque environment, the opposite of transparency, would be one in which an investor simply has to trust that the money that they're they're sending to the companies is being used well.
Does that work in capital market?
It doesn't work at all. We've found in all the modern developed economies, starting with the United States and Western Europe, that transparency, which is insisted on by the accounting regulations and by the Securities and Exchange Commissions, has always promoted greater investments in capital markets.
Thinking about emerging markets, can we compare, let's say, Eastern Europe and Latin America? How are these markets developing? It's not easy to compare in bulk.
Yeah.
But
and comparing them, they come from very, very different legal traditions, very different cultural traditions. For example, Latin America has had a very long tradition of family businesses and a sort of a private view of businesses. So disclosing information publicly has always been and will continue to be, I believe, in Latin America, a difficult issue, because culturally there's been, publicly has always been and will continue to be, I believe, in Latin America, a difficult issue, because culturally there's been a tendency to keep information. Companies were nationalized, they were state-run enterprises, and now they've been turned over to more public entities where they're open to inspection by outside investors. So it's been less of a problem in places like Poland and Czechoslovakia and those kinds of places. You've seen very rapid development of an integration into the European economies. So very different traditions, and I think both the legal traditions and the cultural traditions are different in those two parts of the world.
And compared to China?
Compared to China, Latin America is a little bit closer in some ways there, because again, in China there's been this tendency to retain information about your business within the family, within the group, and there's been less disclosure of information, less willingness to let outsiders see what's actually going on inside a business. This is a result. Contemporary capital markets are less. There is some interest in China, but that interest has been held back by the lack of transparency in those markets. So in some ways, Latin America is a little closer to Asia than it is to Eastern Europe.
Dr. Spindt, thank you very much for sharing these ideas with us. And thank you.